As we have discussed, an Excel workbook is a file that contains more than one worksheet. By default, when you create a new workbook, three worksheets are included in the new workbook. Now I'm going to demonstrate a little bit about worksheets and how to manage them and work between them. And you can follow along. Let's go ahead and open up a new file. So let's come up here to our Office button, select it, choose New by clicking it once. This will open up the new workbook dialog box. This should look familiar. We've gone through this earlier in the tutorial. Keep the settings at the default settings so we can open up a blank workbook. Click Create, and we'll now have a new workbook. Notice that it does have the three sheets by default. These are worksheets, and you can switch between them by simply clicking the sheet. Now, it looks like there's not much difference up here because we do not have any data in any of our worksheets. Let's go to Sheet 1 by selecting it. Click in cell A1 to select that cell and make it active, and then go ahead and type Demo 1. Let's do the same thing with Sheet 2. Click on Sheet 2. Make sure you are in cell A1 and type in Demo 2. Go ahead and select Sheet 3, and again make sure you are in cell A1 and type Demo 3. Press Enter to enter that data from your keyboard, Enter, and that will move the active cell down to A2. Now notice when we click the Sheet tab, we will switch between and you can see the new data of each worksheet. Now you can also name a worksheet by simply coming down here to the actual name of the sheet that you want to change and double click it, that name, and that will highlight it and you can name it whatever you want. Let's go ahead and call this Demo 1. You can name this two or three words if you wanted to, but it's recommended that you try to keep your worksheet names short in size so that they don't take up as much real estate down here just with the name of the worksheet, but you can use multiple word names. So let's go to Sheet 2, double click that. We'll call this one Demo 2, and Sheet 3, Demo 3. Also note that you have an Insert Worksheet tool or button right down here next to the very last worksheet. In our case, that would be Demo 3. If I select that, it will create another worksheet. I can add another one and another one, and notice that as you add more and more worksheets, you're losing the ones that you had created earlier on. You can go back to worksheets that kind of flow between here. Right now I have six open by using these tools right over here in the lower left corner. The first one takes you back to the beginning. The one here on the far right will take you to the end. And each of these are kind of like stepping you through the sheets until you can view the entire group of sheets that you have. You can go back through the other way as well. Take a moment and play with those. You'll find that worksheets are real easy to use. If you need to rearrange the order of your worksheets, let's say I want to move Demo 3 in front of Demo 1. I would select Demo 3, and then by clicking and dragging, notice I get this little triangle. I'll click and drag and set that worksheet in front of Demo 1. The triangle indicates where the worksheet will go. So here I'll grab Demo 2 and I'm going to position it in front of Demo 3. So I have Demo 2, Demo 3, and Demo 1. I can move multiple worksheets at once. Right now I just move them one at a time. So if I want to move multiple, I would select the first one that I want to make active or to move, and then holding down the shift key on your keyboard, select the other worksheet that you want as long as it's adjacent to it, and you can even hold down the control key and add to that group. So now I have demo 2, demo 3, and sheet 4 selected, and I want to drag these all right after sheet 5, so I'll go ahead and drag them there. And notice now that I have demo 1, sheet 5, demo 2, demo 3, and sheet 4. So you can rearrange your worksheets. If they are adjacent to each other, hold down the shift key to select adjacent worksheets. If they are not adjacent, hold down your control key on your keyboard and then click the worksheet and you can select them. If you need to delete a worksheet, so let's say I want to get rid of sheet 5, select it and then right click with your mouse on the sheet you want to delete. And notice you get a shortcut menu that allows you to choose quite a few options. The one we want is delete. Let's go ahead and select that, and it will delete the worksheet. You also might get a dialog box asking you if you wanted to delete that worksheet as a warning message. Go ahead and select that by answering yes. Mine, I've got that turned off right now. So anyhow, you can delete a worksheet by simply right-clicking on it and choosing delete from the menu. Let's go ahead and apply some of these techniques to our product list. So go to your product list. It should still be open on your system. And notice that we have generic names of Sheet 1, Sheet 2, and Sheet 3. Let's go ahead and rename Sheet 1 to Product List. And then click anywhere in your spreadsheet to set that name. And then come up here to your Office button and save your worksheet.